ask you a question?
What?
Describe mommy. What color is mommy?
Light brown.
Light brown? Okay, what color is daddy?
Skin color.
If somebody said to you, are you black or are you white, what would you say? Beige. I like that answer.
You constantly have people not understanding where to put you, not understanding like when you don't fit into any of the buckets that they already know to exist for a certain ethnic group.
So it's like either box didn't work.
I identify myself as South Asian or Indian American. That's how I would identify myself.
My family is from the Deep South. Leena and I are both in mixed marriages. Although Leena and I might be very conscious of race, we obviously don't know what it's like to be a mixed race person.
Mm-hmm. So following mixed race stories across America.
What are our kids experiencing? Mm-hmm.
Nice to meet you.
What's going to happen to them as they're discovering their identities?
Hello. Why is a group about biracial identity so valuable for you?
People say, oh, I forget you're black. Or I only look at you as Asian.
Action.
Mommy, you don't say white people, you say the people of not color.
Nobody knew how to do my daughter's hair.
Have you tried coconut oil?
No. Like a handful?
No.
No. No.
I think most white families put the peanut butter
in the fridge. And black people leave it out. You don't. We don't put peanut butter in the fridge.
When I was growing up, I thought race was a bad word.
I think it is absolutely necessary to talk about it and not to just like pretend, you know, that like people don't notice race and people don't notice like multiracial identities.
New developments tonight in the death of Tamir Rice, who was shot and killed by a Cleveland police officer.
This weighs heavy on me because Elias will start walking to school with his buddies.
I looked to my husband and I said to him that I was really glad that my son looked more like him than he did like me, because I wanted to use every ounce of his white privilege to protect him.
So my husband said the other day, I am fearful of the first time someone calls one of our kids a racial slur.
For me as a parent, that's the moment that I dread. Like, that is the moment that I know is coming. And Caty and I have to have this conversation with him. It is now here.